Hello, thank you so much for clicking on this video today to learn more about accessible documents. Today, I'm going to be showing another accessibility tip and showcasing how to make accessible links and why it's important to make links accessible in a document or any type of electronic content. Without further ado, I'm going to go straight into my demonstration to show how to make an accessible link. Today, I have an example of an agenda in Microsoft Word to showcase how to create accessible links. And on the first page here, I have a list of shared documents. And these documents are hyperlinks on this page. Some of them have display text, which is the actual title of the website, web page, or resource, whereas some of these links only showcase the URL. And in order for links to be accessible, they need to read the accurate actual title of the website, in this case, the actual document that people are going to be led to once they click on this link, or web page, or even if there's a particular section or article on a website that you want your viewers to know that that's where this link is going to lead them to once clicking on it, that is very essential to put. And this is important because accessible links, when they showcase the display text or the actual title of the link, this helps not only any individuals who are either blind, have low vision, have visual impairments, but this also helps any individual with a disability if they are utilizing a screen reader to read a document or any type of electronic content. Because if a URL is showing up on any type of electronic content or a document, and someone is using a screen reader to help read aloud this piece of information to them, when it comes to the link and it reads the URL of https://, and then et cetera, that is going to most likely confuse the individual on the other end, leaving them wondering, what in the world is this? And why is this important to me? Why is this included in this document? Why do I need to know this? So the first steps of what you'll want to do in order to make a link accessible is you'll want to find your hyperlink in this document. And I'm going to go down to the third list item in this list here that reads Southern Region Annual Workforce Development Survey Dashboard. And we not only have what this link is actually supposed to read, but we also have the URL hyperlink. We're going to go to this hyperlink first, and we are going to highlight the hyperlink and right-click on that hyperlink. You can also do this by placing your mouse cursor on the hyperlink and right-clicking on the hyperlink as well. And once you've done either of these options, it's going to bring up a list of options as well. And underneath where it reads paste options, there are four options also to choose from that include hyperlink in the options. And what we're going to click on is edit hyperlink. And this should bring up a window that reads edit hyperlink. And it also lists and includes two fields, one on the top that reads text display, and then one on the bottom that reads address. And the one on the bottom that reads address is where that URL hyperlink is going to go. And where it reads text to display on the top field, that is where we're going to put our actual title of this link. So I'm going to erase that URL in this field, and I'm going to paste the actual title from what I had gotten from this page. And all I'm going to do is click on OK. So now this hyperlink should read the display text. The other way of going about this, since I do have my display text as well as my URL, is by actually placing the hyperlink URL within the display text that we actually have here in this list. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight this hyperlinked URL, and I'm actually going to use a keyboard shortcut to copy, which is holding down Control and the letter C on my keyboard. And then I'm going to go up to the display text. And just like I had showcased previously with the hyperlink, I'm going to highlight this display text. And I'm going to press down Control and the letter K on my keyboard as my keyboard shortcut to get to the insert hyperlink window. And so in this insert hyperlink window, already at the top, on the top field text to display, it's showcasing my display text. And then at the bottom on the address field, it's not showing anything. So this is where I'm going to paste in my hyperlink by using my keyboard shortcut of pressing Control and the letter V. And all I'm going to do is click OK. So then we have our display text hyperlinked link. So I have the same example of this agenda, but now it is a Google Doc version of this agenda. And in Google Suite programs, you can also create accessible links. So I'm going to go back down on this page to line list item number 3, and I'm going to highlight this hyperlink, and I'm going to use my keyboard shortcut of Control K. I'm going to press that. And what it's going to bring up is a box or window underneath the link. What it shows is the field for the hyperlink or URL, which has a magnifying glass by it. And then it also has a field that reads text. And in the field that reads text is where I'm going to place my display text. So I'm going to place Southern Region Annual Workforce Development Survey Dashboard. And I'm going to press Apply. And that is going to make my link. So I'm going to undo this using my keyboard shortcut of Control Z. That's going to bring back my URL or hyperlink. And next, I'm going to highlight my hyperlink. I'm going to copy it using my keyboard shortcuts. And then I'm going to go up to the display text. I'm going to highlight that display text, use my keyboard shortcut of Control K. And then instead of this showcasing two fields, one field for the URL and one field for the display text, since you are highlighting the display text on the page, it's actually only going to bring up one field. It's only going to showcase a magnifying glass symbol. And this is where you're going to paste your link in here. So I'm going to paste it using my keyboard shortcut. And then it's going to showcase the hyperlink that we just pasted. And I'm going to press Apply. And this is going to create our accessible link. And then I'm going to get rid of the hyperlink right here. And then you're all good to go. So you can actually even create accessible links in an email using Gmail or even Outlook. For my example today, I'm using an email through Gmail. And what I have here is an email that reads, "Hello, please refer to the Academy for Professional Excellence website." It has the URL after the display text that's just separating it by a colon, and then it reads "for more information." So the first way of going about this is what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight my URL in this email, and I'm going to press Control K as my keyboard shortcut to bring up the actual hyperlinked version of this URL. And underneath the hyperlinked URL, it has a rectangular shape that reads "go to link." It has the hyperlink that you can click on that could lead you straight to your website that you want to go to. Or it also has two options that read "change" or "remove." And what we're going to do is we're going to click on "change." And what this brings up is a window that reads "edit link." It has two fields, one that reads text to display, and this is where you're going to put your display text. And then it also has another field that reads to what URL should this link go to. By default, since we've selected the hyperlink, it already has the URL in here. But for text to display, instead of the text to read the URL, we are going to put in the display text, which is Academy for Professional Excellence website. And I'm just typing this in. And all we have to do is just press OK in order to apply that. And now we've got our hyperlink that doesn't read the URL, but rather it reads Academy for Professional Excellence website. The second way of going about this, which I'm just going to undo that. And once more, I'm going to highlight the URL as well and copy it using my keyboard shortcut. I'm going to go over to where it reads the display text of Academy for Professional Excellence website in this email. I'm going to highlight that, and I'm going to press my keyboard shortcut of Control K in order to apply this URL to the display text. And it brings up the same edit link window, again, with the text display field and the to what URL should this link go to field. What we're going to do is we're going to paste the link into the to what URL should this link go to field. And after we've done that, all we have to do is press OK, and that should apply it. As a follow-up and recap on links, again, links must read display text instead of URLs in order to be accessible. If possible, links must be integrated into sentences where it reads naturally, rather than just putting the link at the end of a sentence. And display text should read the actual accurate title of the web page, website, and or resource, or again, in these examples, the documents that are shared, instead of reading display text such as click here for more information, or here, again, because if someone's reading a document using a screen reader, they won't know what that link is. And it's best to always just put the display text of the actual title of what that resource or that what that link is, and so they know where they're going to be led to. And lastly, again, this is very helpful for individuals using screen readers or assistive technology to access this information, to read it, and also to understand what this link is. Again, this is especially helpful for individuals who are blind, have low vision, have visual impairments, or have any disability while using these accessible tools and technology to help them participate. Thank you so much again for clicking on this video today to learn more about creating accessible links. If you have any questions while trying some of these tips, and if you're experiencing any confusion or have any questions about it, please feel free to reach out to me. My name is Courtney. I am the CWDS Accessibility and Compliance Remediation Coordinator, and you can email me at cketchum@sdsu.edu. Thank you for your continued interest in accessibility, because this is highly important as it may impact your trainings as well as how you interact with individuals out in the field, whether you are an Academy staff member, CWDS staff member, or even a service provider that you are partners with us, training for us. You may have an individual that you're engaging with or who is a participant in one of your training events that may require accessible documents and electronic content that is accessible in order to participate and actively engage in the training or in the conversation. So this is really important. We appreciate the work that you do, either if you work here in the Academy or are a service provider working with the communities that you serve. We hope that you have a great day.